Data modules prepare data coming from many sources for analysis and visualization. Business users can quickly and easily combine enterprise, departmental, and other data. With Cognos Analytics as your co-pilot, data types and relationships between tables are discovered automatically. In this video, you will see how to create a data module using a zip file which contains multiple files, how automatic joins are created, how to add additional tables, a review of the split, group, and clean functions, how to create and use a navigation path, how to format currency columns, and how to create filters. The coffee sales zip file was downloaded from the IBM Accelerator catalog. It can be found by searching for coffee. The zip file contains sales receipt, customer, store, product, and calendar data as individual CSV files. Using the uploaded zip file, I created a data module. The tables were loaded sequentially when the data module was created. When columns with the same name were found, relationships were created. For example, in the product table, product ID is a key that represents a row in the table. The sales receipt table also contains product ID, and in this case, it identifies what product was sold. Cognos Analytics understood this relationship and created a join. Cognos Analytics could not find a connection for the New York City weather table to any other table, and for that reason, it is not joined to anything. I can create joins between tables by selecting the two tables, right mouse clicking, and create relationship. I select the columns that I want to create the joins on, and when I do that, I see the sample data, and I can see visually that they're the same. Clicking match selected columns and OK, the join is created. You might have noticed the ones and ends at the ends of the relationship lines. They tell me some additional information about the data. For example, if I look at the generations and customer, I can read that relationship as for every row in generations, there may be multiple customer rows that belong to that generation. You may hear people say it as there are one to many customers for a generation. Now I want to add a fiscal calendar to the data module. I've downloaded a fiscal calendar from the IBM Accelerator catalog that starts April 1st, and it's been uploaded to my content. To add it, I select Add Data Sources. I'm in my content. There's the file I want to add. I click OK. And it appears in my relationship diagram. To join the fiscal calendar to the sales receipt table, I select the fiscal calendar and then sales receipt, right mouse click, relationship. In the fiscal calendar, I'm going to use the date, and I'm going to join that to the transaction date. Renaming a column in the data module can provide consistency in dashboards and reports. For example, in staff, renaming first name to a more business-friendly format. Split can be used to extract parts of dates and time fields. For example, split can be used with start date to extract the higher year. If there was a requirement to always show a person's last name in uppercase, this could be done easily using the clean function. By aggregating data into groups, analysis can start at a higher level, moving to finer detail. For example, positions can be put into executive, manager, and staff groups. Formats can be applied in the data module for consistent use in dashboards and reports. Doing it once in the data module saves you from repeating the action every time a column is used. For example, the currency format can be applied to line item amount, so it always shows the dollar sign and has two decimal places. Simple calculations can be used to create new data. If line item amount was not already in the sales receipt table, I could have calculated it using quantity and unit price. Changing the operator to multiplication, and then giving the new calculated field a meaningful name. A navigation path is a collection of non-measured columns that a business user might associate for data exploration. A navigation path can be used in a dashboard or report to drill down on or back up to change the focus of analysis. For example, being able to follow a path from a city down to a store address. To create a store navigation path, click Create Navigation Path. We're going to open Sales Outlet and drag City, Neighborhood, store address over, and give the path a name. To see the store's navigation path in action, I created a bar chart with city and line item amount. Hovering over New York and right mouse clicking, I can select drill down. I now see the neighborhoods within New York. Selecting Manhattan, I have the options now of drilling down further to another level or drilling back up. When I hover over the level and right mouse click, I can use Navigate to move directly to a specific level, and in this case, I'll see all store addresses for all neighborhoods. Filters can be used in a data module to limit data for specific use cases. To create a filter in dates for just weekend dates, I select day of the week, filter. And select Saturday and Sunday. I can see that the filter is in place by expanding the members and seeing just Saturday and Sunday. I also see a filter icon appearing, letting me know that a filter has been defined. When columns from tables joined to dates are used with columns from the dates table, only data with weekend dates will appear. It should be noted this method is not intended to provide secure data. How to do that will be covered in a separate video. Filters can also be created for use in reports and visualizations. Clicking More, Filter, the filter pane opens. To create a filter for coffee beans, I'm going to create a filter for product category. This filter is now available for use in a dashboard or report after I save my data module. Folders can be used to help organize your data modules. In this case, I'm going to create a folder for my filters. I can drag and drop the filter I just created inside my folder. Switching back to the dashboard that I'd created earlier, you can see that the sales is for both New York City and Long Island City, and that's for total sales. If I wanted just to see coffee bean sales, I could go and pick up the filter I created, which we see in the filters folder, and drop it on the tab. Filters applied, and now my sales are showing just coffee bean sales. This concludes the video on how to create a data module with multiple tables. You've seen how to create a data module from a zip file, how to add a table, how to prepare data for analysis, and how to add and use filters. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.